in the world of NASCAR. Richard Petty Motorsports, we all know, is a 43 Chevrolet. And the driver from the NASCAR Cup Series, Eric Jones, joining us here on the Rich Eisen Show. How are you, Eric?
I'm doing good. How are you guys?
Where have I found you? Where in these United States are you right now? Where are you?
I'm in Charlotte. So I grew up in Michigan, lived there until I was about 16, and I've lived here in Charlotte ever since.
Okay. So, Eric, is it a true story that you and I are not only lockstep with Power to the Patience, but about the Michigan Wolverine football team? Is that a true story?
We are tied together on the Michigan Wolverines.
Okay, which has also caused us to be hospitalized in recent days. So, but not this year, right? Not this year, correct? Right.
This year's been good. This year's been good. Nebraska was a little overwhelming at times.
Dicey.
But, it's been a good year.
Yeah, it got a little shaky in the turns. Right. Got a little shaky in the turns with Michigan. What led you to get into a race car ever for the first time? What led you to that endeavor, Eric Jones?
Yeah, I mean, long story short, you know, I was 7 years old when I started racing and go-karts in Michigan, and just grew up as a big car fan. My family was in the Corvette parts business, so I was always around Corvettes and cars in general, and was really interested in it. I was a casual NASCAR fan, as was my family. You know, we always had the race on, but wanted to do it, and my mom actually got me into it, of all people, and got us racing. And once we got started, it was kind of, it's kind of like wildfire. I mean, I loved it from the start. I was a competitive kid, and going out and racing that, it just kind of fueled that desire. And plus, loved cars and loved being around them. So being able to go out and do that, you know, it kind of fed both of the things I loved as a kid, and to, you know, to this day. I mean, it's obviously a lot different than what I was doing then, but
sure.
I still love every part of it.
What do you mean your mom got involved? Walk me through that one. What was that?
So she was a nurse, actually, and she was traveling home from a conference and read a magazine article at the time, and it was about quarter midgets, which are the go-karts I started racing in, and it was racing for kids. You can start as young as 5 and race up till until you're 16 if you want to. And so she brought it home to us and said, hey, this is a told my dad, this is something I think Eric would really like to do. And he wasn't so sure about it. I think to him sounded pretty expensive. And, he's like, I'm not so sure about this. And she basically said, well, look, we're going to do this with or without you. So we went racing, and that's how it started. And he fell in love with it right away, you know, doing everything we did with that. So it was a pretty cool journey.
So, you know, being NASCAR fans, you said casual, but fans nonetheless growing up, what does it mean for you to be in Richard Petty's 43 in this world, Eric?
It's been a pretty cool journey.
Yeah.
You know, this was my first year with him, and getting to go over there and race for him, obviously getting to know the king and meeting him and spending time around him has been really cool. You know, I wasn't sure going into it how much he would really be involved with the race team and with everything that goes on with it. But he's at the shop all the time when I'm up there. We actually had a test yesterday here in Charlotte, and he was at the track all day long from about 10 o'clock till 5-6 o'clock. So he's around it and loves it, you know, just lives, breathes, and wants to be in racing all the time. And that's really cool to me. So just get to spend time with him and talk with him and have a chance to drive the 43 car. I mean, that's a pretty big honor, to be honest.
It sure is. That's so cool, man. I mean, like, you just see it and you know 43, you know, like that is like Jordan's 23, you know, like, you know whose number that is, you know, and it's
absolutely.
That's so cool. Do you refer to him as the king? Does he ask to be referred to as the king? Like, what is it like?
I've always referred to him as the king. I can't say I feel that comfortable calling him Richard. He's never corrected me either, so I guess I'm gonna keep calling him the king.
Seriously, is that when you see him, like when you saw him yesterday, you refer to him as the king? Like, hello, the king? Like, is that how you like start a conversation?
It is. Yeah, I've always referred to him. Yeah, I knew him a little bit before this season. I've seen him at the racetrack around all the time, but never really sat down and talked to him for a long time, but. That's how I've always referred to him.
Would you guys, I'm talking to my guys here in the studio, would you mind referring to me as such from now on? Would you mind?
I don't think so.
What do you mean? I'm asking you to do that.
I know,
Eric, what do I do with these guys?
But you haven't previously been known as
Eric, you know teamwork. Everybody's got to row in the same direction, figuratively, for you guys to win your race. Right, Eric? Like, everybody's got to be on board.
If everybody's not on board, it's not going to work.
Of course. Thanks. Come on. I'd like you to start right now, is what I'm saying. It's getting awkward in here, Eric.
Can we wait till the next
King
hour?
Richard.
Oh, gosh. So, I appreciate you joining. It was great to see, you know, a sponsor of ours involved with your car as well. That's pretty cool, man. So, that's part of the reason why we wanted to have you on, too. So,
no, it has been cool. I mean, getting to work with Power to the Patients. So, I met everybody involved over there a few weeks ago. Mm-hmm. And, you know, to be honest, it's been a learning experience for me. Knowing what their mission is and what they're all about. I didn't know, to be honest, there was a law passed that requires hospitals to show their prices up front. I didn't even know that. So I had a long chat with those guys a couple of weeks ago, just kind of asking what their mission was and what they're really all about. And it was pretty cool for me to learn about it. You know, we've had some family history with medical costs. And so I know the general struggle there with what bills can be. So it was pretty interesting and enlightening to, you know, see that you can go into these places now and you can get prices up front, and really, you know, it's going to make for a competitive market in that field. So really, I love to learn. So, you know, that was cool. I learned a ton here in the last 2 weeks about what they're really all about.
Eric, thanks for the time. Really greatly appreciate it. Let's do this again real soon. I'll be looking for you out there on the circuit, and great chatting with you.
All right. Sounds good, guys.
You
thanks
got it. That's
me.
Eric Jones joining us at Eric_Jones, Twitter and Instagram, right here on The Rich Eisen Show. Hey, you watched all the way to the end. Thanks for that. Watch more right here.